Royal Crown Church of God welcomes you to your place of royalty, where you are treated like a king and a queen, prince and princesses. You are before the King of Kings, who is your chief host.
Hebrews chapter 4 verse 14 says, "Seeing then that we have a great high priest that is passed into the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast our profession." Your understanding, my friends, bets your convictions, which further determines your output for victory. Let us pray. My Father, my God, I thank you for today's meeting and encounter with you. I thank you for bringing us from across the globe to hear from you this morning. We ask, O God, that you teach us by yourself. Lord, we do not take our past encounter for granted, but we know, Lord, that your mercy has given us the privilege and you have imparted us so much. Please teach us today. Help us to know you by your word and help us to be doers of your word. Thank you because you're a faithful God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. It has pleased the Lord to feed us today from his table. As I serve you as his chief servant, the meal, hold fast to your confession. Part 4b. Hold fast to your confessions. Part 4b. So we are still dealing on the good ground, which is the part 4. We started last Sunday and we continue from this Sunday, and only God knows how long it's going to take us, because we are going to take our time to deliberate on this good soil. We are not concerned with the past, but we are concerned with the present. How do we achieve victory when it comes to holding on to our professions, the things that we believe about God? Because we know that there are challenges and battles ahead of us. How do we achieve them effectively, so that when trials and temptations and persecution comes, they don't swallow us, they don't submerge us, they don't defeat us, but we emerge victoriously as the Lord has planned us to be? That is why we are taking time on this aspect of the good ground. Praise God. We need to understand what needs to be done, because you see, all of them were ground. In the context of the scripture, the Bible uses the heart. All of them are what? Are the same heart. But in the course of time, things began to unfold and things began to happen. Some chose where they belong by their response to the word of God. And that is why you have the wayside. It is their own response. You also have the stony ground response. You also have the turning ground response. And now the good ground is also respond. How did they respond to the word that made it a good ground? They were all grounds. So we are going to be looking at that, because it will help us as believers to survive in this test time, in this time of trials. If we do not understand this, when temptations and trials come our way, we can cave in quickly. Praise God. So, and our text remains Matthew chapter 13, verse 8 and verse 23. Let's look at that again. The Bible said, "But other fell into good ground and brought forth fruit, some an hundredfold, some 60-fold, and some 30-fold." Verse 23, "For he that received seed into the good ground is he that heareth the word and understand it, which also beareth fruit and bringeth forth, some hundredfold, some 60-fold, and some 30-fold." Praise God. You can see one basic thing in that aspect. It said, he hear the word and understand it. Praise God. Others did not understand. They all heard it. when they did not understand. But for the good ground, what happened? He heard also like every other ground had. But one thing is that he understand it. He understands the word. Amen. And it is the understanding that, you know, brought forth the fruit. Praise God. It is the understanding that bears the desired fruit. You understand me? Every one of us have our level of understanding determines what we get. It is like in exam hall. The question has been given to us. One of the things that helps you to write well is how do you understand the question? And secondly, is that aspect or the subject that you are going to answer, you have read it. Did you really understand it when you were studying it? Some of us can take up a note, just one page, and half of it, we have answered that question. Some of us can answer a full page. Some of us can answer in two pages. What are we writing differently? Is it not the same thing I know that you are writing? Yes, but we have different understanding to it. So our understanding determines our approach to it, which also determines what you get. And if you write well in two pages, writing nonsense, you will not be rewarded. But it's also possible that in two pages, you are writing every nook and cranny, everything that has to do with that same subject that somebody has just written with five lines. So you discover that what you are receiving is tied to your understanding to what you give. Praise the Lord. It is the understanding that gave birth to 60-fold, 30-fold, 100-fold. They did not understand it the same way. So this good ground is actually the determinant or the determinant factor to every other heart. The basic and the summary of all this, all of them had, but all did not understand. The one that understood took extra step. It is like the five wise virgins. The 10 wise were virgins. Five were wise. Five were not. The one that were wise understood, had extra understanding, and they took extra step to their decisions. I want us to pray this morning and say, Father, help my understanding in your word. Help me to develop understanding in your word. Help me to know your, to give time. Because for you to understand, you need to give yourself to the word. If you don't give yourself to it, you can't understand it. Help me to be hungry of your word. I want to carry confessions that will sustain me in the time of trouble. Because when the Bible is talking about some 100, some 60, is talking about even the virgins. Some with wisdom, and they took extra step, which gave understanding or result to what they receive. Praise God. So I want us to pray to God and say, Lord, help me. Help my understanding in this world. Help me to know you more, oh God. Develop my insight in this world. Can we pray to God? Help me to know you. Build me in your word. I want to know it deep. I want to know you deeper than I know. I want to know you better than I have known. I have not gathered anything at all. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You know, we're talking about the qualities of the good ground. And the first thing we mention is still receptive. We mention a book of James chapter 1 verse 21 that talks about openness and humility that allows the word to step in. For you see, that the good ground did not just understand. It has openness. It was open to the word. Amen. It was open and it was humility. It was humble to the word. Praise God. So he didn't just arrive at a good ground. Something happened. He worked on himself. And other things that made the good ground to receive the word was the understanding. Amen. He also had faith. And he was reading and kept reading and kept believing and kept hearing the word. You see, his understanding was poor also by what? Persistence approach to the word of God. Now, I have to read Proverbs chapter 2, verse 1 to 5. The Bible said, "My son, if thou will receive my word and hide my commandment with thee." First thing is to receive and to hide commandment. If you will receive the word of God and hide his commandment with thee. No, now say, "So that thou incline thy ear unto wisdom and apply thy heart to understanding. Yea, if thou criest after knowledge and lifted up thy voice for understanding, if thou seeketh her as silver and search for her as for hid treasures, then shall thou understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of God." The approach to the word. Until you do this, approach the word like this, as we mentioned in Proverbs 2, you can never find the word. You see the understanding. There are approach with all your heart, openness, humility. Until we approach the word in such manner, we may never get it. That is why some people can read the Bible and yet they will never see anything. It doesn't get open to anybody. A lot of people have read it, yes, and boast about it, but when it comes to understanding, they are telling us about letters. The word of God is beyond letters. They are not letters. Praise God. A lot of people think that it is just the letters there. No. The Bible said the word became flesh. This same word of God became flesh and dwelt among us. So we must prepare our heart to receive that flesh, the impact of the word that became flesh. See beyond A, B, C, D needs. The Bible is beyond the world. The Bible is not really the word like many of us think. The word of God is hidden in the Bible. The word of God is preserved in the Bible. The word of God is life and spirit. The Bible is like an envelope that preserves the word of God. So the word is beyond letters. I've seen people say, "Oh, we are tearing the Bible." You are not tearing the word. The word of God is beyond the letters in the Bible. But the Bible is good because the Bible has preserved the word. Amen. So, and we need to hear consistently to build our faith, because for me, faith is boldness. How do you feel when you're under a motivational speaker? Over time, you begin to see yourself bold to respond to what he has said. The Bible and the Word of God is the greatest motivational message that can equip us and get us that boldness, which is faith, to stand in the test of time. Praise God. Now, in Psalm 119, verse 130, the Bible said, or let us look at it this way. This verse speaks to the enlightenment and understanding that comes from being open to the word of God. Amen. It helps us to understand, enlightens us. You go through it, it enlightens us on the understanding that comes with being open to the word of God. Amen. Praise God. Helps us to understand what it takes to understand the word of God. The openness we apply to the word. How do we get it? What do we make of it? That is what the Bible is trying to let us know. Amen. Praise God. Let's look at Psalm 119, verse 130, and see what God is trying to let us know in that place. The Bible says, "The entrance of thy word gives light. it giveth understanding to the simple. When you open yourself, the light permeates. When you open up your heart, when you humbly open yourself to the word, the light of God permeates. And what is the light coming to do? To disseminate what? Darkness. Or to decimate darkness. It's coming in to decimate what? Darkness. Praise God. And as we give ourselves to it, darkness fizzles off. Amen. Praise the Lord. So you also see in the book of Acts of Apostles chapter 17 verse 11. Say the Bereans are praised for their eagerness and diligence in receiving and verifying the word. These are the things that the good ground did. He gave himself what? To openness. Not just open up himself. He knew that when I open up myself, the word of God will find access into my life to decimate darkness. And are the things that give it understanding. As a Berean Christian, when they get home, they begin to look at the word and said, these things the man of God has said, is it correct? What can we make out of this? And as they begin to do it, the word gets opened to them more. As they pray to God for understanding, the word of God gets opened to them. Praise God. Praise God. I want to also pray once again and say, Father, help me. Help me. Help my approach to the word of God. Please forgive me every form of stupidity I've shown to this world. You may have shown disdain to this world. You may have shown yourself that, is it not the Bible? You can hold it anywhere. You can read anything. You can just open it and begin to read. And you think that as you begin to read, it is just like that. Pray to God and say, Lord, help me change my approach to this world. I want to know you more. And I want to know you deeper. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now, the second aspect or qualities of the good ground is understanding. Understanding. Now, we're going to take an introduction to this aspect, but we're not going to dig deeper. Amen. Good ground allows a seed to take root and grow, indicating an understanding of the word. It means comprehending spiritual teachings and allowing them to deeply influence one's life. That is what a good ground means. And by next Sunday, by the grace of God, we are going to continue or take up this message from this place. Understanding of the good ground and the qualities of the good ground as it helps our lives. And I pray that as we do that, or as we continue to brood and meditate over the things of heart today, the Lord will impact us with his word in the name of Jesus Christ. I want us to pray this moment and say, Lord, help me, help my understanding, help my receptiveness. I want to be receptive to your word. Everything that makes the good ground good, I want to receive this morning. Have mercy on me, O Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You are here too. You are not born again, and you want God to be the headstone of your life. Quickly make the confessions as it is shown to you on the screen. God bless you. Amen.